what's up, guys? Got another new video here for you. This is Bars Unlimited, back with another reaction video. My name is Bryson, and this is my brother Bennett, back for some more reactions. Today, we are getting back to NF for the first time since me and Jake reacted to his song Breathe. And in that video, Jake had never heard that song, but I had, and I was a huge fan of it. And I requested that we do that one, and just to show him. Now, in this scenario, I have never heard of this song Lost featuring Hobson. As a matter of fact, I still have not listened to his newest album. I was staying away from it, hoping to do a song or two off the album for the channel, and just never got around to it. And, you know, right when this album came out was around the time when me and Jake had not been recording for a while. And so it was just kind of bad timing, the way that it worked out. So me and Jake had not checked this one out, and I hadn't gotten to it. And like I said, I was trying to save a song or two up from the album. Anyways, this is his song Lost featuring Hobson. I think that NF with Hobson is going to be a really interesting combination of artists. I can see where it would work, because Hobson in his own right is very, he shares a lot of his own personal struggles and things as well in his music. So I could see where they kind of, a collab would make sense, but at the same time, I never really would have expected to see it. So I think this is going to be very, very interesting. What do you think?
Yeah, it definitely should be. You know what? I've actually grown to like Hobson the more I've listened to him. Like, I think the way he can rap and, you know, just flow over tracks is pretty insane. I mean, especially considering, I mean, he has like 9 Ill Mind of Hobson tracks. I mean, shoot, that must have been hard to continue, you know?
Yeah.
He probably ran out of ideas as he kept doing it, you know?
You think, but he keeps on doing it, so.
I know, it's pretty insane. I mean, that just goes to show, like, how talented of an artist he is.
Yeah, and all of the Ill Mind ones are great, too. They're not just, like, throwaways.
Yeah, my favorite ones are actually, my favorite two are the most recent ones, 8 and 9.
Yeah.
I thought 9 was really nice because he, you know, told the story of how him and his wife, you know, had a fall through or whatever, and he lost his son because of it. I just thought the way he told that was really something else. I thought it was a really good, well-written song. And also, I mean, 8, the beat on that is just nasty. I really like it, and he flows so well over it, too. So it's...
Yeah. Now, he personally is not one of those people that's, like, hopping on every single NF album when they drop. So I'm interested to see how he... not to say that he doesn't like any NF songs, but at the same time, I wouldn't necessarily say that he's, like, a huge NF fan that's, like...
Yeah.
You know, waiting all year for the new album to drop or anything.
I mean, there's definitely a song or two by NF that I have heard and I like, but for the most part, I really haven't listened to much of his music. I'm not going to say he's really a bad artist or a good artist, because I haven't listened to enough to really know.
Yeah, I honestly think that if you gave his music more of a chance, like if you actually listen to an album or two, you would really like it, because he's got a lot of deep personal messaging in there that it is relatable to everybody, you know, about struggling in life and things like that. And that's something that you don't need to be, you know, the most literate person in the world or anything like that to understand. And with that being said, I think that's why he has a large following, because the truth is that you don't need to be somebody that understands the whole hip-hop lingo and everything to be able to follow along with his music. A lot of times, his music is things that everybody has experienced, and not just not just if you come from a certain environment or you grew up in a certain neighborhood or something like that.
Yeah, you know, I will say one thing, though, that I notice is a lot of the, like, I see a lot of, like, watch a lot of highlight videos for sports and stuff, and they're constantly using his songs on them.
Yeah.
Like,
he's got great production. I love NF's production for the most part.
Yeah, I mean, my favorite song by him, I mean, from the ones I've heard, is probably Leave Me Alone. I really like the dark sound of it, and just the melody to it is really nice, too.
Yeah.
So I just...
But, again, with the combination of hops in here, though, I don't know how that's going to sound. That's going to be... I'm really excited for this, actually. I'm interested to hear how this sounds. I mean, it's weird to think of what kind of beat these two... Like, you know, the type beats. Hobson / NF type beat. What would that sound like? I can't even...
I can't even
picture it.
I can't.
So let's see. Let's find out. What do you say?
Yeah, let's do it.
NF Lost. We got the lyric version here. So if you guys want to follow along with the lyrics, they'll be in the corner. And yeah, let's check it out. NF Lost featuring Hobson. Okay.
Definitely sounds like Hobson.
Really?
I can picture Hobson on this.
See, that's really interesting because I have listened to a lot of Hobson, but the moment this came on, the first thing I'm thinking is, wow, that sounds like this is 100% NF 101. And the first thing that he said, having not listened to very much NF, is, wow, that sounds a lot like a Hobson beat. So I guess what that means...
I just can picture Hobson on this.
So like, I guess that means they did a great job with production that... works for the two of them. So, yeah. You know what I mean? Because that was weird how...
To me, it sounds like something... I don't know. I recall hearing this kind of sound on a Hobson song before.
And there's multiple songs that sound like this on NF. So...
Yeah.
All right.
So, I mean...
That's a good sign, though. It sounds like the production... I'm excited. Let's keep it going.
Look,
this might slap.
Self-awareness, pride's a coat and yes I like to wear it. Buttoned up, don't like to let no air in, with a pair of gloves that I hope doesn't perish. I discovered though when I get holes in them and I let joy in, I'm in higher spirits. My mistakes are like a screaming parrot, just repeating lyrics. I can barely bear it when I'm lost. Road is narrow, I'm looking down it like a gun's barrel. Aren't we all searching for the serum that could help us breathe and leave our state of peril? All of us have made defensive scarecrows that we scatter around our fields and treat like heroes. When they scare away the things that we should cherish, cause we're too embarrassed to admit the fears that we're lost.
Wow.
No.
No, I don't know what I said. I really like the way he was flowing at the end of that. I was like,
yeah,
you know?
All of us have made defensive scarecrows that we scatter around the fields and treat like heroes.
Oh. Dude, man, I cannot wait to see this beat drop. Cause, I mean,
yeah, and I know we stopped it literally right as it dropped. So I know
NF
a lot of
does
you
a good job of
building up to the beat.
To the beat.
Yes, he does.
Yeah.
He is legendary at that. I just love this whole part right here, though. He said, aren't we all searching for the serum that could help us breathe and leave our state of peril? I mean, amen to that. Everybody's searching for the key to happiness, so to speak. You know what I mean? Like, how can
we could all use it right now, for sure.
Yeah, especially right now. I mean, everybody's looking for a quick fix kind of thing.
Yeah.
And then he said, all of us have made defensive scarecrows that we scatter around our fields and treat like heroes. That is such a deep line, you know what I mean?
I don't understand it.
So I think basically what he's saying is we all have these things that maybe we're not proud of, or actually, you know what? I think I'm misreading that. All of us have made defensive scarecrows that we scatter around our fields and treat like heroes. And then he followed that by saying, yeah, but what does it matter? I get so competitive. Oh, no, because we're too embarrassed to admit the fear is that we're lost. So, first of all, he tied fear in with Scarecrow and stuff like that, like the scary portion of it.
Yeah.
But I think what he's basically saying is we're all hiding behind something that we, you know, maybe in front of people, we try to make it seem like, oh, yeah. You know, like, for instance, somebody that is maybe shy or is shy, maybe they're trying to impress somebody, so they, you know, are super outgoing and super, like, energetic and stuff like that to make it seem like they're not. But deep down, they're scared. You know, they're scared to death, like, oh, my God, I'm out of my element. I'm out of my comfort zone. Mm-hmm. I could be wrong on that, but nonetheless, just the lyrics were really beautiful there. And what he was trying to say with that, I may have mixed up, but I just love it so far. So let's hear what this beat drop sounds like, though.
They scare away the things that we should cherish, cause we're too embarrassed to admit the fears that we're lost. Yeah, but what does it matter? I get too combative inside of me's a personal canvas. The paint can be flat, I get messy when I start to get rattled. The heart of a savage and pride when I lurk in the shadow. But something on that up, I don't want to be overdramatic. But look at the data, it's obvious that humans are fragile.
I don't think this is the only beat drop, for sure. I don't think this is the final, like, the final, I think there's gonna be more. Like, this is, like, little kind of a build-up. Like,
yeah.
It came in a little bit, but I think there's going to be one more that will bring in, like, the full beat.
Dude, I love this.
No,
he sounds
good,
and his flow is excellent. Throughout this whole song, his flow has been excellent.
I'm excited to hear Hobson on it, just because I think he'll be pretty interesting. But I definitely could picture Hobson on this. Like, for whatever reason, I can totally picture Hobson on it.
All right, let's see.
Be overdramatic, but look at the data. It's obvious that humans are fragile. We tend to get mad at the ones that call us out, but the fact is we need someone that'll be honest when we fly the handle. Woo! I am here throwing fit when I begin to unravel. Keep my wits been off the grip, and now I'm back in the saddle. My intent is not to wait, I like the onward I value. I can take you on the fence and maybe pick up the paddle. I like the world against the current, that's the way that I travel. Opposite of what the grain has got the brain of a rebel. Take initiative, I'm diligent on every level. I never can settle, I like to keep my foot in the pedal. Yeah, I love to pack arenas and all. But what I really wanna do is learn to handle my thoughts and put the reins on them, show them I'm the one that's the boss. And I'm back when they get out of hand, I'm breaking their jaws. I'm taking the flaws, they told me I can never revolve. Then pull a bane on them, ask them, oh, you think you're in charge? You ought to know better, ain't no way around it. Applaud the traits that I want, they say I can't afford what it costs. But I manifested this. Failing's how you grow and learn your lessons, kids. Take the worst and try to make the best of it, cause when you fail, just know that it's a test in it. You can learn and pick yourself back up again and train your brain to not be such a pessimist. It's okay to make mistakes, just don't forget that there's a high road, but I skip the exit when I'm lost. Yeah. When I'm lost.
Okay. Wow. Dude. I knew that wasn't the final beat. Like, then they brought in, like, the hi-hat, and, man, that beat really came together for me. I thought that was pretty nasty.
Dude, this
production is really good.
Dude, and this is how Hops, or NF songs are. He builds it throughout, and then there's multiple different parts of it that come out.
I love that he was using a kind of orchestral sound on it for the production. Yeah, I think that sounded great. I mean, it really fits the song, too.
Yeah, it fits NF, too, because he's always kind of dark and stuff, and it kind of ties in with the darker sound a little bit.
Mm-hmm. No, it sounds good. Definitely.
Yeah, dude.
NF is definitely killing it. He's
flow-wise, for
good.
Sure. And his lyrics are really, really good. I mean, listen, guys, a lot of them are kind of straightforward. I mean, and I like the one where he said, oh, you think you're in charge? He made the Bane reference. You know?
Yeah.
Oh, that was cool. Just a Dark Knight reference. So that was cool. I mean, we're big Dark Knight series fans, so... That was cool to see that in there. I love NF. I mean, he's just awesome, and this is no exception. All of his songs, the production is like this, where even when the beat isn't doing much, he's building it with his intensity and his voice. And then all of a sudden, you're just waiting for it to just come in.
Yeah.
I mean, he's got it. He understands what sounds good in terms of, like, how to match the beat intensity with his voice and how to build it, I guess. Like, build the intensity and build the excitement and anxiousness for what's coming. He just knows how to do it. I mean, it just sounds great.
Well, I mean, and then look at this. I mean, we haven't even listened to Hobson's part, and we're already feeling it. So, it's, you know what? I'm really looking forward to getting into Hobson's
verse.
I'm sure that's coming up pretty soon after this chorus, I'm sure.
Yeah, let's see what Hobson sounds like. I'm excited for this.
Yeah. When I'm lost.
I like that.
When I'm lost. When I'm lost.
Real quick, I know that they're about to probably have Hobson's part, but this right here, another one you could totally see in, like you said at the beginning, a basketball video on YouTube in the background, or at a basketball game when the players are practicing and warming up. I could totally hear this playing. 100%. This sounds like something that people would be doing layup drills to. 100% to me. I could picture myself doing it back when I used to play. Like, this sounds like something that I could see in the background of something like that. Like a compilation video on YouTube of football players or basketball specifically, just because, you know, that's a little bit more hip hop, I think, basketball is, than I kind of picture hip hop.
Most NF songs I've heard on highlight videos have been on football.
Really?
Huh. Yeah, so I don't know.
Nonetheless, I could just picture this in like a hype video type format. I totally hear it. As a matter of fact, I wouldn't be surprised if it's already on a few. Really. So, anyway, let's get to Hobson.
Lost. When I'm lost. When I'm lost. Lost. Wow. These burdens are heavy, and I'm hoping it don't bury me. I used to be joyful and skip so merrily, but now I'm too cautious and tiptoe carefully. My mind left, and it's nowhere to be found. Am I a big old parody? Cause it's no fair to me. And now I'm at the point where I'm spending a grand a week on hypnotherapy. Look, I'm trying to wash away my sins. I got a group of loved ones that ain't my friends. And if I ever take a nail, then they might grit. And they all want to see me stay in the cage I'm in. So when it come to anybody, there's no trust for no one. Man, so what? My whole plan's to go nuts. My shoulders ready for most drugs. I'm gon' judge anybody trying to into my circle with no love. My sanity's gone, I'd rather be torn from this planet they planted me on. Yes, that's a reward. I'm actually born with heaven in sore heart. It's torn apart from a family that I don't have anymore.
Oh, Jesus Christ, man. This is fire. This is so fire. First of all, NF sounded great, but the way that Hobson is rapping too, and just the way that the beat is building up again, him being who he is and how he does kind of the same thing as NF in a lot of his songs. As the beat starts building, he starts
becoming more aggressive.
Yeah, becoming more aggressive. And it's amazing that I would never put these two guys in my mind. I would have never pictured them on a track together. But now that I'm sitting here and I'm listening to this, it makes perfect sense. And I'm thinking to myself, what took him so long? This is genius. Yeah. This is great. I mean, oh my goodness. I mean, this is amazing to me. And I love what Hobson is talking about here. You know, he even said something about he's got family who would probably grin if he started to have things go wrong. You know what I mean? Which is real. There's a lot of, you know, kind of like, hey, just because your blood doesn't always mean family and things like that. And just a lot of different lines in here that are so real.
What was the line he said about planets and planted? He said something about planets, about the planet he was planted on or whatever.
I don't know, but it says, but I really enjoyed the hypnotherapy line. That was cold. I used to be joyful and skip so merrily, but now I'm too cautious and tiptoe carefully. My mind left and it's nowhere to be found. Am I a big old parody? I
mean, oh, wow, that's a pretty genius line. I never thought about that, but yeah, that's a good line.
Because it's no fair to me. Look, I'm trying to wash away my sins. I got a group of loved ones that ain't my friends. That was the line that I was talking about. So when it comes to anybody, there's no trust for no one. Like I said, that's a real line right there. And then, man, so what? My whole plan's to go nuts. My shoulder's ready for more shrugs. I'm going I just love it. I mean, it sounds really, really good. So, oh, and here's the planet line. My sanity's gone. I'd rather be torn from this planet they planted me on.
Oh. So,
anyway, cold. I mean, this is great stuff from Hobson. He's being super introspective, talking about his own life and things that are going on with it. And obviously, as we know from other songs, you know, his past relationships and stuff have especially the one that left him in the situation he talked about in
Illmind 9,
obviously a relationship like that will leave some scars in your life. And the fact that he can't see his son, it just goes to show that, you know, just because you're blood.
That's why it's, like, that's one of my favorite songs by him, because it's a deep song. And, I mean, it just, like I said, the wordplay on it is, I mean, shoot, it doesn't get much better when you're talking about a life story. Mm-hmm. I mean, to me, the way he wrote it, I don't think there was really anything better he could have done with it. it just sounded great.
Yeah. So, let's finish this up.
Yeah.
I'm gon' judge anybody trying to enter my circle with no love. My sanity's gone, I'd rather be torn from this planet they planted me on. Your status reward, I'm actually bored. What happened in sore heart is torn apart from a family that I don't have anymore.
Man,
I was living so oblivious for millions. It really was a pity, huh?
A pity.
It's kind of funny what a penny does mixed in with a mini buzz.
I feel stuck.
Wow. Life got me by the neck with a blade against it, cause I was running late for the train and missed it. The only thing I feel is pain and vengeance, so I'ma act out like a raging misfit. And every verse I Lego stay sadistic. You wanna hate me? Good, great, terrific. You'll never see the day when my anger's dismissed. You better go and change your wish list, cause manifested this. Do not treat me like some adolescent kid. I am praying to the Lord with the book of James, hoping he go wear my testament. This dark cloud, that's my residence. Demons knocking, I don't have to let them in. I done made mistakes day to day, you probably can't relate. I just ain't the same when I'm lost. Yeah. When I'm lost.
Dude, I love the way he switched up the flow at the end.
Yeah.
He went to kind of like a triplet flow, kind of. It reminded me of the triplet flow that Migos always uses.
Mm-hmm.
But it wasn't really quite that, because he did it a little bit slower than Migos.
Mm-hmm.
But still, I really thought that sounded good. I mean, shoot. Again, I mean, Hobson, to me, he can adapt to really any type of beat. I mean, he can change up his flow and still sound really damn good.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just he's definitely one of the more talented artists out there, and I've always, you know, from the songs I've heard from him, I'm a pretty big fan.
Yeah.
And, I mean, his voice is just really good, too. Like, his rap, like, I don't think he uses that auto-tune at all.
You just like the sound of him on the track.
Yeah, I like him in most songs. I mean, I think, you know, his vocals and, like, for rapping, to me, is really good. I mean, CDTV the G, he always talks about, like, rappers' vocals and stuff, and, you know, I would have to say if he had to rank Hobson, I'm sure he would have him up there pretty high.
Yeah.
In terms of just how he sounds.
Yeah.
I really like him. So yeah.
Well, I mean, getting into the song as a whole, I thought the song was great. I love the title of it is Lost, and both guys were kind of talking about, you know, Hobson was talking about how he's feeling lost because the people that he's supposed to be able to count on the most, his family, he's having issues and issues and issues with that kind of lead him to feel like he can't really trust his family. And that, you know, blood doesn't really mean anything. And as far as NF was talking about, you know, he was kind of going along the same lines, but he took it a different direction from family and was talking about other things. But both of them were talking about how they're just kind of confused and lost and in a state where things aren't really making sense to them. And yeah. I just really enjoyed that. I mean, they're being honest, they're being real with where they're at. They're giving you kind of a behind-the-scenes look at who they are as artists, and they're not scared to do that. And they both came together on a track and attacked the same kind of concept with from different angles, which is really, really cool.
You know, the song that kind of made me think Hobson would be a good fit on this song was Kumbaya, or whatever, that one?
Yeah, Kumbaya. Mm-hmm.
Kumbaya, my lord.
Yeah.
That beat, the beat he uses on that track kind of sounded similar to this one.
Somewhere. Yeah, I can hear a little bit of that. Speaking of Kumbaya, I was just going to say, make sure if you haven't yet, go check out that reaction that me and Jake did, because we have a reaction to Kumbaya on this channel.
I really like that song, honestly. So, it's pretty good.
Yeah, definitely go check that one out. But anyways, guys, you know, in closing, I think this was a master degree level of knowing what artists to pair together, and whichever team, or whether it was both of them that decided to come together and do this. I don't know if it was Hobson's idea or NF's idea or both of them, whoever was responsible for putting these two artists together really did a masterful job and really has a good ear for music and knowing what's going to sound good. I don't think that even though I feel like this was definitely an NF type song, like you could hear NF all over this. If you listen to NF albums,
yeah,
the moment it came on, you're like, yep, I could tell. Even if you did not tell me who was on this song, the moment it came on, I could have told you, oh, NF.
Yeah.
It literally has the handprints of NF all over it. However, I think Hobson was just like a natural fit. It was almost like you said, kind of like the song was made for him too, even though it's 100% something that you could tell would be on an NF album. So I think production-wise, they killed this. Lyrically, they killed this. And flow-wise, they both went insane. The beat was super fire. I love how it built, and it was catchy. I enjoyed the chorus, even though it was a little bit repetitive, but I don't even mind that because it wasn't really about that, to be honest with you. It's not about having the greatest chorus in the world on this song. It was more about what they were talking about in the verses, exactly. Which is what I really listen to these artists for. I mean, a lot of times. Like, for instance, Hobson, he hasn't exactly blown me away with a lot of his choruses. But where I enjoy listening to him is some of the verses that he has within his songs. You know, he really has some insightful words and lyrics and stuff. NF, some of his choruses I really like, others not so much, but the same thing. When I listen to his verses, he has a lot of deep, powerful lines in there that just make you say, like, wow, that's so true. Wow, that's so relatable. And
yeah.
I feel like the collaboration of the two is just ingenious. I really hope that this is one of those deals where NF, you know, Hobson is featured on a NF track, and then Hobson has a track down the road featuring NF, and they do like a, you know, single for single kind of thing, where, you know, one is featured on the other's album, and then the other is featured on their
album. I'd like to see a collab album.
Well, that would be cool, but I think that's kind of asking a lot.
That's probably not gonna happen.
Yeah, exactly. Realistically,
that would be cool.
Realistically, that probably won't happen. But given that fact, if we can just get one more song from him, that would be awesome. Because this was awesome. I mean, this was
when
far
was this
better.
When was this song released?
This year.
This year?
This is off his newest album.
Ooh, awesome.
So I 100% hope that they collab again in the future, even if it's just on another track, or, you know, like he said, if they could do an album or just a couple more tracks on an album or something, that would be absolutely dope. Because, as I said before, and just to close out the video, I did not picture these two on a track together, but now that I've heard them on a track together, I think it's glorious, and I want to hear more. Because if the way that Hobson is and the way that NF is, I just think their styles match perfectly in terms of making music. And if they could keep the production in this kind of area, or even go a little bit more Hobson side, I'd like to hear what NF sounds like on more of a Hobson type beat. That would be cool too. So anyways, guys, thank you for watching this video. If you like the video, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe, drop a comment if you have any thoughts, or if you'd like to hear us check out more songs off the NF album, or if you have any suggestions from Hobson that you'd like us to check out, we'll be sure to do that. We think both of these artists are dope, if you couldn't tell by this video. And as I've said in past videos, NF is personally one of my favorite rappers, so I never have a problem checking him out. You know, Bennett definitely always enjoys himself as well when we check out these different artists.
Oh, yeah.
So, you know,
no,
especially
totally.
in the rap side, that's kind of what
No,
Bennett's...
that's kind of the main reason I joined Bryson for these videos, is because I love especially listening to, like, rap music. That's something I don't know, you know,
yeah.
I like listening to, and especially... when we got good speakers here, it's easy to want to come out and be like, oh, what's... instead of just sitting there listening to it in the background, I can sit here and actually get my thoughts on it.
Yeah, exactly.
So. And plus, I mean, when we're recording these videos, we're always listening to new songs for the most part. So it's always something, there's always something I could possibly add to my playlist. So it's, you know, like there's no... definitely no downside to it.
Yeah, exactly. And with that being said, you know, on a closing note, definitely gonna have to check out the rest of this NF album. And you know, after this video is over, I will probably get to doing that, because NF is awesome. And now that I got this video out of the way, I'm ready to listen to more. Because if the rest of the S album is anything like this song was, holy shoot, you probably should even check it out. So anyways. Like I said before, thank you guys for watching this video. I'm Bryson.
I'm Bennett.
See you guys in the next video.